We can no longer practice the soprano model of running masjids. We can no longer run our masjids like we're Marlon Brando in The Godfather. We have to open up the masjids to our young generations. We have to give our young people the right to participate in our communities. And we have to eschew being Sufi or Salafi or Ikhwani or Tablighi and realize that first and foremost, we are Muslims. And that's where we need this maturity, this Islamic maturity that we lack. When we go to defend a PhD thesis, we're mature. An MA thesis, we're mature. But when it comes to issues of the Muslims, we become like my three-year-old son. Temper tantrums. We have masjids in Birmingham where, subhanAllah, they will tell you, the people in this masjid are deviant. The people in this masjid are deviant. Ya Allah, we have more flavors than Baskin Robbins now. But how is it that we can even fathom working with non-Muslims when we cannot even work with our own fellow Muslims? So unity. And look at the unity and the maturity of the others. Imam al-Dhahabi, who was the student of Ibn Taymiyyah, he criticizes Abu Hamid al-Ghazali, rahimahullah. But after he mentions all of the critique of Abu Hamid al-Ghazali, he says, "What? فَأَيْنَ مِثَارُ أَبِي حَمَدٍ فِي تِلْكَ الْأَيَّامِ?" Where is the example of Abu Hamid in these days of ours, in his worship, in his zuhud, in his knowledge? Rahimahullah, hujjatul Islam. Look at his maturity. A Shafi'i, rahimahullah ta'ala, who argues with his student, and his student becomes so angry that he gets up and he runs. Imam Shafi, he grabs him and he says to him, "What? Don't forget our brotherhood." So what binds us is stronger than what pulls us apart as a community. And we have to eschew political differences and lack of sincerity. Wallahi, I'm going to take longer than 1 minute because you gave me 20 minutes. Can I take more than 1 minute? And I'm very sorry. But I have a message to give you. So I have to deliver this message. Number two is the responsibility which we talked about. Imam al-Shafi'i, this maturity, he runs and says to him, "Don't forget my brotherhood. Don't forget our brotherhood." Ibn Hajar, who criticizes Ibn Taymiyyah. Ibn Hajar is a Sufi, he's an Ash'ari. But what does he say about Ibn Taymiyyah? He says Ibn Taymiyyah, he has the right to these decisions because of his level in knowledge. Look at the maturity. Now, I don't like this one. Why? He's from this group. I don't like this one. No. Number two is the responsibility of the family. Fathers, spend time with your children. Fathers, quit making i'tikaf in front of the television. Fathers, quit going home and shut the door. Be kind to your children. Tell them that you love them. Spend time with them. Kiss them on the cheek. And let you know that you would be nothing if it wasn't for that pillar, the unconditional love, the support, the mercy, and the strength which you took from your women in your household. So as families, love each other, forgive each other. Don't leave this lecture tonight with a problem with your husband. Don't leave this lecture tonight with a problem with your wife or with your children. Forgive each other because you're gonna die. You're going to meet Allah and you're going to have problems with your children when you meet Allah. What will you say? Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara. Who you believe, save your family from the hell. So make a plan every week to spend time with each other. Mothers, read to your children. Reading has a major impact on the life of young people. Fathers, spend time with your sons. Don't let the streets raise your children. Don't let television raise your children. You raise your children. And the last, after the brush of the community and the brush of the family, and one of the colors of the family is this love. The Prophet used to tell Aisha, "I love you." It's not cool now, it's not macho, it's not 50 Cent to say that you love your wife. But you don't follow the sunnah of 50 Cent, akhi. You follow the sunnah of Rasulullah. And the last and most important brush is the brush of the youth. You young brothers and sisters here today, Your responsibility is so heavy. And imams of the community, I was raised in the West. I went to high school in the West. I went to jail in the West. And then I became Muslim in the West. Then I completed my university studies in the West. I am a child of the West. I am an American Muslim. And I have no shame. It is not an anonym for me to say American and Muslim. And these young people now, you have to understand you are British and you are Muslim. Don't tell me you're going back home. You home. This is where you live. And your job is to worship Allah on this land. Because the poet says, Zindagi be bandagi sharmindagi. So young people, what colors will you use for your brush? I was reading in the newspaper on the way here, the great results of people in this country. And in the last four out of the 10, I found Muslim countries mentioned. Young people, are you in the house? Next year, when I come back, I want to see you in the top 5. Can you do it? Because one of the greatest acts of worship you can do now is to do well in school. So number one, young people, to do well in your education. Number two is to develop this connection with Allah. Before you do anything, a concert, a song, an act of comedy, anything, take it back to the fuqaha and ask the scholars, is this right, is this wrong? And scholars, you have to understand that growing up in the West is hard. These young people don't live in Karachi, they don't live in Cairo, they don't live in Kuala Lumpur, they live in the hood. And believe me, it's difficult, and we understand as imams that you young people are going through difficulties. And our message to you is, keep struggling. We support you. You're gonna make mistakes. If you make mistakes, we'll be there for you. This is the message that we need to give to young people. We're not to indict you, but to invite you and to tell you that we're proud of you and we believe in you, because you represent the fusion of the Western Muslim identity. And indeed, the painting which lies before this community, this empty canvas, will be painted by the hands of the youth. You will paint this canvas. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless all of you. And as I leave tonight, I want to leave this brush in the hands of the young people. It's your job to paint this picture. Wassalamu alaikum rahmatullah.
Brother Imam Suhaib Webb.